Hi, welcome. This is Sivasankar. Welcome to English grammar class. Today, we are going to describe about the types of adverb. So, dears, let me know first of all what do you mean by adverb. It is the parts of speech, one of the parts of speech. Then, but you know about the what do you mean by what is adverb? This is our question. Let's discuss about what you mean by adverb. Our answer is adverb is a word which denote or describe about verb or adjective or other adverb in the sentence. What is adverb? Your answer is adverb is a word which denote or describe about the verb or adjective or other adverb in the sentence. This is called adverb. Then let me know how many types of the adverb. Then we should be know about the types of adverb. Let me know types of adverb. First one, adverb of manner. Second one, adverb of place. Third one, adverb of time. Fourth one, adverb of frequency. Fifth one, adverb of degree or quality. Sixth one, adverb of region. Then seventh one, adverb of affirmation or negation. Adverb of affirmation or negation. Then eighth one, adverb of interrogative, or you should be write the interrogative adverb. Interrogative adverb. Then ninth one, adverb of conjunction. conjunction. And the last one, relative adverb. Relative adverb. These are the time types of the adverbs: adverb manner, adverb place, adverb time, adverb of frequency, adverb of degree, adverb of the region, adverb of affirmation, adverb of interrogative, adverb of conjunction, adverb of relative adverb. So these are the 10 type adverbs. So we are going to learn about this one by one. Let me know adverb of manner. Okay, let me know about the adverb of manner. This type of adverb, it shows the action how, and how the action take place in the certain time or certain period. Let me know about what is that. Slowly, fastly. Calmly, quiet. So these are the adverb of manner. It shows the manner of the adverb to describe about the verb. Let me write. He run fastly. This is the manner of adverb. It describes about the verb. So how he can run, so that is describe the this adverb. That's why it is called it show the manner, what kind of the running he had done, what kind of running of action is done by him. It shows the this adverb of manner. Let me write one more. They sit quietly. It means they are sitting. How they are sitting, it describes the this kind of the manner about this verb. This is the first of all adverb of manner. Let me know second one, adverb of place. Adverb of place. Let me know this adverb you can be used where the action the happen, the exact place we can be. So that is called a adverb of place. Then what is the words we can be used for the adverb of place? Here, there, in, out, below. These are the word we can be used for the adverb of place. Let's go to write them one of the some of the example. You can come in. You can come in. It means in this in it so and describe about the come. It means very come. In, inside. So this word is and this adverb is describe about the verb word. Thus it is called a adverb of place. They are playing there. and this is the adverb of place. It describes where they are placed. So these are the, it's called a adverb of place. Let me write. And third one. And third one, adverb of time. Okay, this adverb, it shows the when the action happened, when the action done by someone. When this is so the time. What is the time? You can write since, now, then, today, yesterday, still. These are the kind of the adverbs. It shows the time. Early, you can write early. Late. These all are shows the time. So it is called a time of adverb. Then how we can be present in the sentence? Okay. He gets up early every day. It means this is the early. It shows the adverb of time when he wake up. We attended the party yesterday. Then this is the yesterday, the time of adverb. It describes when you attended, when we attended. So we attended yesterday. So one of the party. So it so describe the time of adverb, right? Read the school too late. It means this late is so the when he reads. So this is the time of adverb. Then next one, we have go to the fourth one. Adverb of frequency or number. Then fourth one, adverb of frequency or number. Okay, this kind of adverb, it shows the, so when it oftenly happen, when it happen, it is always, or the sometimes, or once, or twice. So it is the, so the exact number, or it is so the daily. So this kind of the adverb, we can be say the frequency or number, adverb of frequency. और नंबर वर्ड इधर दैट इज ऑलवेज ट्वाइस वंस regular. So these kind of the adverbs we can be present in the frequency or either number. So this is the frequency always. You always visit our home. When he visit, this is the action of the verb. So when he visit, it shows the always. Then this is always describe about the verb. So he always visit their home. That's why this word is this adverb of frequency word is describe about the when he visit always. We take a meal twice a day. We take a meal. Okay, this is the action. We take a meal. How many times the frequency or time or number of the adverb it shows the how many times you take a meal per day. So this is the what frequency or number of the adverb. Let me know. He is a He purchases goods regularly. When he purchases means, so every day he had to be purchased. You can be write the every day also. Every day instead of the regular. So these kind of the adverb, it shows the frequency or number. Then we have go to the another one. Fifth one, adverb of degree or quantity. So we can, it is the measure the degree and quantity, the how much the action has done. So that is called a adverb of degree. Let me know some of the word. What is it? Little. Very. Too. Much. More. So these are the degree of adverb or quantity of adverb when we describe about the verb. So how much of the action is done. Okay, Children take little food. Children take little food. It means how much they take, describe the little. How much quantity or how much degree. It describe the, so this is the degree of quantity. Then this is the verb, it describe about the verb. She talks too much in the classroom. Like how she talks, we have to say the degree or quantity. She talks too much in the classroom. It describes the about the verb. How much it talks? It's 2 months. It means moreover cross the word. So this is the fifth one. Let's go to the next one. Sixth one. Sixth one, adverb of region. It means sometime we have to mention the region to describe about the action. So on that time we can write the adverb of region. Then what is that? Therefore, hence. See, these are the words we can use for to write the reason to present the what is the action. He is not interested therefore. He left from the classroom. Okay, it is the reason, so why he left? It is the, so the reason, adverb of reason, why he left? He is not interested. So this is the word it is exclaimed before the why he left from the classroom. Okay, next. She is too weak. Hence, can't concentrate. She is too weak, hence it is the, so the reason why. Why she can't concentrate? This is the word. It describes about this. Why she can't concentrate? She is too weak. Hence she can't concentrate about the sword or maybe. So this is the adverb of reason. Okay. The next one we have to know about the seventh one, adverb of affirmation or negation.
So it is next one, seventh one, adverb of affirmation or negation. Okay, let me know what is affirmation, what is negation. Affirmation, when we go to confirm, so that is called affirmation. Negation, when you say no, it means the opposite word, that is called a negation. Then what is the affirmation? Adverb of affirmation is yes, surely. Confirm. So these are the affirmation. So when you come to the negation, no, not, never. So these are the adverbs we can write in the different kind of the actions. So one of the affirmation, when you say yes, sure, confirm. Then when you say no, not, it is a negation. So let me go to write some of the example of the affirmation first of all. Yes, I will attend the program at any cost. This is, you have said confirmly, then this S is, it give the what is the whole action. It means definitely you have to attend or not. So this adverb of affirmation, it give the confidence. So next one, better to write some other example. He surely solved this problem. He surely solved this problem. It means that surely the adverb of the affirmation, it gave confidence. Definitely he solved the problem. Let's go to the next one, negation. So come to the negation. They never make any fault okay they never make any fault at any cost. At any cost, it means it is a give, they never make, it means definitely they never do that, the any fault at any cost. They give the negation, but it is so the they never make hard work. You can write they never make hard work. You can write one more sentence, they never make hard work. If they never shows the, so definitely they can't do that one. So when you not, He is not at all a good person. Not at all. It's not shows the definitely not a good person. This is the adverb of the affirmation or the negation. The whole, what is the affirmation? And the definitely confirm. The negation is the, we said no. The quite opposite of the. Okay, then next one you have to go. The eighth one. The adverb of conjunction. So then when we have to give the sum of the region, join the two conjunction, join the two words or the two clause, two phrase, and that time you have to present the adverb of conjunction. So that is, therefore, still, since, that's why. So these are the adverb of conjunction which we have to present the joining of the some of the word or conjunction. Let me know, write some of the example. She felt ill, therefore she couldn't attend the office. She felt ill, therefore she couldn't attend the office. He is working in the factory, still getting old. Still and therefore, this is the joint of the adverbs. Two conjunctions, they have to be joint and describe about the what the happened. So this is called a adverb of conjunction. Let me know. Ninth one, interrogative adverb. Then no, ninth one, interrogative adverb. Then what do you mean by interrogative adverb?
So when we make questions, to want to ask questions, on that time definitely we have to use double H words. Those double H words is called a interrogative adverb.
They have the different types of double H words. What is it? When, where, how, why, who, and these are the different reason we can be make a questions. If you, when you want to ask,
when, the time, the period, so on that time you can be make the when double H word, the adverb.
When did you borrow this product? It means you have to ask the when did you borrow this product. When you when did you bring, sorry, borrow not bring.
When did you bring this product? It means you are asked the when the period that action happened. So it is called a interrogative adverb. Then where, you ask the place.
Where does she work at this time?
Where does she works at this time? So it is ask the place where she works daily. So then how? It means the it is the degree. Or how that happened, you have to ask.
How much money do you want?
So this is the quantity, the how much you need. So the quantity of the question you can ask means how.
Why? You ask the reason. Why? Why do you became poor person?
Why do you become poor person? Then why, what is the reason why do you become poor person?
Whom do you take care every day? Who do you take care, or whom you can write, who do you take care every day?
So these are the all double H words. They have the certain, what is the time, place, region, quantity. So these all are we have to ask to interrogative adverb. Then last but not least, that is the relative adverb.
Then 10th one, relative adverb. What do you mean by relative adverb? The relative adverb is a word, adverb, so which joint two clauses or two phrases to give the complete sense of the meaning. So that is called a relative adverb. What is that relative adverb? Who, which, whom, whose, that. These all are called a relative adverb. So when we join the two clauses, then on that time we can be write this kind of relative adverb. I visit a place which I like most. I visit a place which I like most. So this is the one of the clause and this is the one of the clause. These two clauses is joined at the relative adverb. Okay, then write the some other example. I met a boy who is very intelligent. In science and technology. I met a boy. This is the one of the clause and the who is joined to the remaining clause. So this is called a relative adverb. Now let me write the some other. It is a book that I never read at once. That is the relative adverb. It joined the two clauses. Okay, dears, I hope you can understand these all are the types of the adverb. Thank you.